Today in the news, we got reviews of the T-Rex, a pre-bent tablet, and some AI remasters. What's up guys, I'm Snows, and this is your boot sequence. Alright, so the Titan RTX came out a few days ago and the reviews are starting to pour in. Is it worth the $1,300 on top of what you would pay for a 2080 Ti? No. No, it's not. And you probably guessed that much. In fact, the T-Rex actually performs worse in ray tracing compared to the 2080 Ti. Now, this is probably just a matter of optimization, but J2Sense tested the card in Battlefield 5 and it was consistently around 10 FPS slower than the 2080 Ti. With RTX off though, it of course performed better than the 2080 Ti. Now, what is really impressive is how little of an upgrade it is. Sure, you now get the fancy gold trim on it, but the difference in specs aside from memory, as well as the difference in performance, is just too small in gaming. I honestly just hope that productivity testing will allow the card to shine. Guess we'll have to wait and see for that. Moving on, if you're up to date on the Elon news, you might know that they tested the first underground tunnel. The Boring Company's Loop, not to be confused with the Hyperloop, is a high-speed underground transportation system that would see cars and some bus-type vehicles zoom at speeds of 150 miles per hour. Well, the first test of the loop looks promising, but also a little disappointing. The test track had a Tesla Model X seen zipping through the tunnel at speeds of around 35 to 50 miles per hour. They did test it at 110 miles per hour, as Elon said, but it was a little scary. It wasn't driven or controlled by any kind of AI though. It seems like in this case, it was just a skilled driver and some training wheels that would bump on the side of the track to keep the car in line. The invited parties said that the ride was a little bumpy, with some loving the roller coaster feel and others feeling a little woozy because of it. Mr. Musk said that the rough ride was because of problems with the paving machine and that those wrinkles would be ironed out. Honestly, it's still progress, and I have no doubt that this prototype track won't be a hurdle in the Boring Company's plans. What do you guys think about this whole tunnel highway system? Let me know down below. Then we have the iPad Pro. It's an amazing tablet, definitely not something that will replace my PC or any form of portable computing, but it is a pretty powerful device. The first thing I thought when it launched was, why is it so thin? I mean, it's going to bend under any kind of pressure at that point. Well, it looks like Apple is going to take care of that for you, because some iPad Pros come pre-bent for your enjoyment. In all seriousness, a lot of customers are reporting that their device came with a slight bend out of the box. Apple says that the bending happens as a result of a cooling process used on the components when the device is manufactured, and that it's normal. I mean, no, it's not. Sure, it's caused by a process in manufacturing, but you know what they call that? A defect. Especially when not all the iPad Pros have the same bend. Thankfully, if you do encounter that issue, you should be able to exchange it without any issues within the first 14 days of purchase, but it's just an annoying process. Then in gaming, in the past few weeks, we've seen some modders update old game visuals using pretty interesting methods. They're using various AI tools available to the public, and the results are quite amazing. Taking a look at HidFan's work, he bumped up the quality of Doom 2 by using super resolution texture tools from Nvidia's GameWorks and a little bit of Topaz AI Gigapixel. By upscaling everything to 8x and then downscaling them back to 2x, you can see how much of a difference the process makes. He did have to clean up a lot of AI artifacts, but the results are pretty nice. Another team used ESRGAN to create a mod for Morrowind. This one upscales and enhances the quality of the image quite a bit. I mean, look at the difference here. It's so much cleaner. I wanted to talk about this because I have a little bit of a prediction. I have a feeling that 2019 is going to be filled with retro games getting the AI treatment. Not only that, but I think we're also going to get some games with really messed up AI generated sprites just for fun. Imagine a version of Super Mario Brothers with an AI upgraded texture that was kind of trained on real life stuff. This is sure to be freaky in my opinion. Anyways, guys, that is pretty much it for the news. Hopefully you've enjoyed it. Drop me a like if you can. As usual, you can click right here to see the latest video and right here to subscribe to the channel. It would be greatly appreciated. You know, this winter, it's definitely not my best. I slipped and fell 3 times in the same day a few days ago. Anyways, guys, stay frosty, avoid slippery ice, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Okay, bye.